Good morning, everyone, and welcome to the Pivot Boss pre-market video for Monday, March 30th, 2020. I am Frank Ochoa, aka Pivot Boss. Real quickly, I want to invite you to the monthly market outlook that I will host on April 1st, which is Wednesday, April 1st at 4 p.m. Central Time. You can go to pivotboss.ecofin.co. Right up here, pivotboss.ecofin.co. You can sign in and go to the Pivot Boss Community Room, which is where I will host the monthly market outlook. This is a must-attend market outlook, as this is the largest correction we've seen in many, many decades. Lots of great opportunities are already coming to the surface, and we will discuss many of those opportunities from both a short-term and long-term perspective. We will discuss the markets. Again, that will be Wednesday, April 1st at 4 p.m. Central. You can go to pivotboss.ecofin.co. If you do not have an account, it is free to sign up. It is free to sign up, so please join us. And I will also be providing a special deal as well for those of you that attend. All right, let's take a look now at the markets here. Here's the ES in the daily time frame. Obviously, we had a tremendous bounce in the previous session where we bounced up, or in the previous week, rather, where we bounced back toward 2650, rather. We knew that we could get a bounce last Monday, and we thought that that bounce could last for multiple days, perhaps the entire week, and that was right on the money. It even surpassed our estimates here, getting into 2600, 2650. But after Friday's sharp turn down here, we have since gapped down. We have hit the midpoint here from Friday's session and are showing a little bit of hesitation to get above that midpoint right now. That midpoint is going to be very, very important to continue to watch. That's going to be about the 2570 level, and that's basically today's high. So any failure to get above that zone would suggest that we could be due to pull back a bit and a break below the previous week's close price of 2520. A failure to hold 2520 could open up a little bit of weakness here. And if it does, how much of a pullback do we get? Do we get back toward 2300? Do we get back to 2400? Somewhere in this zone could be an easy get here. Now, one thing to keep in mind, if this is going to continue higher, any pullback today could be seen as a failed low or a pullback higher low that could lead to a push higher the rest of the week, so we'll continue to see how that plays out. But right now, keep an eye on the previous session's midpoint, 2570. A failure to hold or get above that level would suggest weakness, and a failure to hold 2520 opens up much more downside. Taking a look here at the NQ. The NQ also pulling back from the previous highs here. You can see price came right into two-day highs and dropped on Friday. Here's a midpoint being rejected again today. We're very close to it. And again, you have a very narrow four-day range, which over here is measuring one-day range right now. Very narrow here. So again, if it were to fail to hold the current four-day range, that could give us a pretty steep dip. If that dip even just retests the low, that would be a tremendous start for April to find opportunities below the previous month's low and look for some sort of recovery bounce. How high does it go? Who knows? But again, this could be a fantastic spot to watch for rejections below the previous month's low. But again, right now, first things first, got to watch four-day lows and see how the market responds to that. Again, a failure to get above the previous session's midpoint here could suggest sideways to down price action. All right, let's take a look now at crude oil. Crude oil on a 512 tick chart is showing a compression of the pivot boss bands. That suggests that we could be looking at a pretty sizable breakout here pretty soon. Additionally, that that range has formed below the previous session's low. And that's very, very important here because there's a little bit of a box there. If it can hold and break to the upside, we could easily be looking at a fill of the gap back toward 2184. That's very simple. And perhaps a push beyond that, as high as 23s or beyond. So right now, we could be looking at a pretty solid bounce here. But again, It depends on which way we break. The pivot boss bands are pinching in the intraday time frame, which suggests that a breakout in either direction could be seen. And if it's to the downside and we break through 20, we're going to open up quite a bit of weakness. And we have already been on a downward path here. So right now, not looking like it has a lot of spring off that $20 level like it did before, but we'll continue to watch the range. All right, taking a look now at gold futures here, you'll notice that gold is still holding near the highs overall. We saw a tremendous bounce here from the 1450 to 1700 level, and we're now holding in a very narrow range over the last four sessions or so. Again, this is a range where we could see a little bit higher above 1700, but we likely fall back inside the range. This market likely stays somewhere between 1500, 1525 to 1700, but can get down as low as 1450. Overall, the movement is to the upside, with upside as high as 1800 to 1820 down the road. So right now, this market right here continues to show strength overall, but at the moment, especially on a 60-minute time frame, you have multiple day compression range, and that range could spark the next move here pretty soon. All right, that is it for now. We'll see how this develops heading into the rest of the session. Good luck, trade well, and I'll see you in the trading room. Take care.